I'm Dr. Mary Tierney, and my position here at Sunnybrook is I'm a senior scientist in the brain sciences program, and I'm also a clinical neuropsychologist in the Veterans Center. The purpose of our study was to determine whether we could predict who was likely to develop dementia due to all causes over a 10-year and a 5-year period. So the tests would measure memory, language, they would measure visual spatial function, they would measure a person's ability to match digits and symbols, long-term, short-term memory. Over a 10-year period, two of them were accurate in predicting who was likely to develop dementia. And these two tests, one was a test of delayed verbal recall. So that was a test where they have to recall 15 words, and they do that over several trials. And then they're given an interference test. And then after a short delay, we see how many of those 15 words can you remember. And the second test was a test where they had to match digits and symbols. So those two tests together accurately predicted who was likely to develop dementia of any cause. And then over a 5-year period, we found that two additional tests were also helpful in this prediction. So in addition to the delayed verbal recall and the matching of the symbol and digit, we also found that a test of long-term memory and of what we call category fluency were added to the prediction over a 5-year term. So this predicted those who developed dementia of any cause, which would include Alzheimer's, it would include vascular dementia, Parkinson's dementia. And we've actually shown with other tests, and other investigators have as well, that Alzheimer's disease can be predicted well in advance. But this is the first study to actually show that dementia of all causes can also be predicted. When we begin to see these symptoms of people, even in the early stages, they may not be evident unless you actually test them, because a person may be able to compensate and they may look quite normal. But from what we know about dementia, there have been brain changes for several years before we actually are able to diagnose it. So what we're actually seeing is we're identifying what the brain changes are up to 10 years before and showing that it really is a progressive phenomenon. But I think the other really important thing is that if we can identify it early, then, for instance, we may be able to motivate people. So we could tell them, well, you know, you have an increased risk of developing dementia, and we can quantify that, tell them what the risk is. That might motivate them to be more careful about diet, improved exercise, just general lifestyle improvements. If you can know 10 years before you will actually develop the clinical symptoms, that means before that time you can do things that are known to delay the onset. You also have an idea of what your future may hold. So, because a lot of patients have complaints, they know there's something wrong. But unless you do these specific tests, it's very difficult to identify them. Other patients may have the view, too, that it's time to get their life in order, make sure that they've assigned powers of attorney, all their paperwork is in place while they're still high functioning, and they can make these decisions. The first thing, when a person has a memory complaint, there are many other causes, and especially treatable causes, that you want to ensure that you've eliminated. So, for instance, if it's dietary or it's an endocrine problem, depression, you want to make sure you identify treatable causes like that first. But if they've all been examined carefully, then possibly administration of these tests may give further indication of exactly what the problem is and what the likelihood of change will be in the future. The test is applicable to people who are 65 years and older, and they may or may not have a memory complaint, and it would give an indication of how they will perform in 5 to 10 years and what their probability of developing dementia is. And but the most important thing is for people to realize that if they or a relative or someone they know has a concern about memory, the most important thing is really to discuss this with your family doctor. Because if there is a treatable cause, then that can be explored and treated. And once that and the proper assessment to ensure that there's no other treatable cause, at that point, then it's probably helpful to have this sort of information.